Are you ready to clap your hands? To lift your voices? For our living God, amen? We are here because the Lord is good, amen? We are here because the Lord is God of all. And He is worthy of all our praises and thanksgiving, amen? Can we give the Lord a mighty roar of hallelujah?
continue to worship you, Jesus, in this place.
Come on, church. Sing Hosanna to the King of Kings.
Raise our hands. Lift up your hands to heaven. And pour out your heart this morning to the one true King. Let now our hearts burn with a flame, a fire consuming all for your Son's holy name. Let now our hearts burn with a flame, a fire consuming all for your Son's holy name. Let now our hearts burn with a flame, a fire consuming all for your Son's holy name. And say it to Jesus. Sing it with all your heart this morning.
Your Son. bow our heads before the Lord. As you sing those songs, ma-feel ba ninyo ang gugma sa Ginoo sa inyong kinabuhi? How God so loved us that He gave His Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, to save us from our sins. That's the love of God. And so we can sing to Him back that we love Him because we are thankful, grateful. And tungod kay, because we have received His love, then we can learn to love people. We can learn to love others. Father God, as we come to worship You this morning, may You be glorified, Lord, when You look at our hearts, that we are indeed grateful, Lord, as we have felt, Lord, Your love for us. Your great, great love, Lord. You are Savior, King. You are Creator of the heavens and the earth. You are the King of kings and the Lord of lords, and yet You died for us because You love us, Lord. Father God, we know we are sinners and we do not deserve Your love, yet You give Your life to save us from our sins. And so today we celebrate that victory that we have because of our Lord Jesus Christ. Yes, Lord, we love You back. We want to worship You with all of our hearts, Father. Today, God, we are ready to listen to Your word and receive Your word. And we pray, God, that You will touch the hearts of Your people. And You will bless, Lord, Your servant na magbigay ng word mo ngayong umaga, Father. Lord, prepare her and everything that will come out from her mouth, from her mind, from her heart. Galing po sa inyo ang anointing mo po ang matatanggap naming lahat ngayong umaga, Father. Lord, aming pinagdasal ang aming mga first-timers that we have invited this morning. You love them, Lord, as You love everyone. Father, we pray as a church that we can show them Your love. We can show them, Lord, that we also love them sincerely, genuinely. Father, teach us to love one another. Lord, we are interceding for our country and our city. Lord, the Philippines is for Christ. Jensen, Lord, is Yours, Father. As we continue, Lord, to conquer the city for You, one soul at a time. At gamitin mo po lahat kami dito, Father. Kaya gusto mo, Lord, maprepare ang aming mga puso para masabi namin sa aming mga kaibigan at mga kapamilya, Lord, Your love ang aming pong ishare sa kanila. At lahat kami mag-celebrate, Lord, as we move forward in the kingdom, Father God. Lord, today, aming binalik ang lahat ng pasasalamat at worship at gratitude sa aming Panginoong Jesucristo na umiibig sa amin. Salamat, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Palakpakan natin si Lord. Woo! Good morning. Once again, mag-greet ta sa ato mga katapad. In a hello, good morning. Salamat kung kita ang katapad karon. Welcome sa mga first-timers. Kung ngayon lang kayo naka-join sa ating worship service, can you raise your hands dyan sa taas? Can you move your hands so mapansin ko yung mga kamay? No, welcome kayong lahat. Dito naman sa baba, may mga first-timers ba? Marami saan? Can you raise your hands? Ah, iyan pala. Okay, welcome kayong lahat. No, ang mata ng pastor nyo hindi na masyado klaro. Kasi ang mata ko 67 years old na. Amen. Excited na ba tayo sa word ni Lord? Okay, let's welcome Pastor Ravan Clemente.
Amen. Good morning. Amen. Sabihin mo sa katabi mo, ako'y nagagalak magkatabi tayo ngayon. Yeah. Amen. Nalipay mo? Nga siya imuhang katupad? Ang uban, wa nalipay. Sige, welcome po sa ating lahat and welcome sa lahat ng mga visitors po na andito ngayon, palagi namin ito sinasabi na dili gyud aksidente nga naa ka dinhi karon. This is your time na makilala mo ang Panginoon. Amen. Hallelujah. And I'm glad na ano na po nagiging ano na tayo sa sixth church na po tayo ngayon. And I would like to ask you kung nagmuni-muni ba ta sa ato ang mga kinabuhi? Nagminumuni ba ta sa ato ang kasing-kasing? Unsa ba ta loveless church? No? Unsa ba ta the kanang compromising, the corrupt, the dead? I hope na, or glory to God, kung naigi persecute din he, the persecuted church. Hallelujah. And my prayer, kung ano la, ano ho yung estado natin sa heart po natin, may ginagawa po tayo. Amen po ba? Amen. Sige. So today, we will talk about the Philadelphia Church. Okay. Philadelphia, makikita natin ito sa Revelation 3, verse 7 to 13. Sige, ang title ng message natin ngayon, Letter to Philadelphia, the Faithful Church, the Obedient and Committed Church. Ganahan po ko ani, the Church with Opportunities. Amen. Malaman natin kung ano ang opportunities na binibigay ni God sa kanila. May I request everybody to please stand and let's read Revelation 3, verse 7 to 13. Okay. Andiyan na po ba? Sige, ready, go. Write this letter. You have little strength, yet you obeyed my word and did not deny me. Look, I will force those who belong to Satan's synagogue, those liars who say they are Jews but are not, to come and bow down at your feet. They will acknowledge that you are the ones I love. Because you have obeyed my command to persevere, amen. 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 I am coming soon. Hold on to what you have so that no one will take your crown. All who are victorious. And I will write on them the name of my God, and they will be citizens in the city of my God, the new Jerusalem that comes down from heaven from my God. And I will also write on them my new name. Anyone with ears to hear must listen to the Spirit and understand what He is saying to the churches. Anyone with ears to hear must listen to the Spirit and understand what He is saying to the churches. Amen. Lord Jesus, Father God, open up our ears, Lord, spiritual ears. Open up our eyes, Lord Jesus. And tagaimig heart, Lord God, that will perceive your word. We pray today that we will understand your word, that we will be like the Church of Philadelphia, Lord God, the faithful church, obedient and a committed church. Thank you, Father God. Thank you, Holy Spirit, for being with us today in Jesus' name. And everybody will say amen and amen. Philadelphia is 28 miles from Sardis. Ang founder po nito, si Attalus II Philadelphus, last 150 BC. It was named after him because of his loyalty to his elder brother, si Eumenes II, king of Lydia. Philadelphia means loving brother. Amen. Or a brotherly love. Ang modern name ng Philadelphia ngayon is Alasihir, Turkey, meaning the city of God, exalted city, or the red city. Tinawag siyang red city po kasi ang soil nila is parang red. Kaya tinawag silang red city. Okay, it was a beautiful and mayaman na syudad. In the 5th century, tinawag po sila ng Little Athens because of the magnificence of the temples. Again, maraming mga temples dito sa mga Diyos-Diyosa nila. And other public buildings. And also there, marami din silang mga religious festivals. The location of this city is near the volcano. Okay? And the soil is good for growing grapes, kaya madaming vineyards doon. Kaya one of their business is a wine industry. Kaya masarap daw yung ano nila, yung mga wine nila. Okay. They rebuilt this city twice because nagkaroon sila ng earthquake twice po. And they were also known by emperor worship. Okay, I would like to show to you the seven church age para malaman natin kung anong yan. Seven church age, kung titingnan natin, meron siyang mga year nga gibutang diha, and sa taas, yung mga stars, sino po ang ginamit ni Jesus aron para mag-awaken, mag-guide sa mga believers anak nga time. Ang Philadelphian Church was the newest and youngest church among the seven churches. Maybe may nakita ako isa na nabasa ko, this is maybe a remnant from Smyrna. And most of the kanang mga theologian, nagsasabi sila nga this was a remnant from the Church of Sardis, the dead church. Kasi it was Martin Luther at that time, nagkaroon siya ng reformation, and then na-birth kini siya na kani, and kini na church, and was transferred to ang revival na pasa siya kay John Wesley. Okay, John Wesley and Charles Wesley, nahitabo ni siya 1705 to 1906, and George Whitefield. So this time, grabe ang revival ani sa Philadelphian Church. This is not a perfect church. Again, let me repeat. This is not a perfect na church, but kung ano man ang desire ng Panginoon sa isang simbahan, nakikita niya sa Philadelphia Church. Again, this church is a faithful church, an obedient and committed church. Alam niyo po, sabi nga ng VOM, sad to say lang po, sabi ng VOM, Voice of Martyrs, kung titingnan po natin ang Turkey ngayon, itong seven churches, wala na ho sila. Parang ano na lang ba, mga ruins na lang ang nabilin ba. But, kasi ang religion is Islam na ho. Islam na ho. And gamay lang jud ang, like, ang Christian karon sa Turkey. Meron ibang Christian, pero iba sa paniniwala po natin. Amen. Okay. Number one, greetings. Sabi ni God. Anong greetings ng Panginoon? Verse 7. Write this letter to the angel of the church in Philadelphia. This is the message from the one who is holy and true, the one who has the key of David. What he opens, no one can close. And what he closes, no one can open. Jesus Si Jesus gi-introduce niya ang sarili niya as holy. True and the one, ano, the one who has the key of David. Holy. He is, ang ibig sabihin, he is God. He is the head of the church, the son of God. Kaya nga sabi ni sa mga disciples ni John sa John 6:39, sabi niya kay Jesus, "We believe and know that you are the son, the holy one of God." In Isaiah 6:3, in Revelation 4:8, sabi doon, the angels declares, "Holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty, who was, who is, and he is to come." Katatlo jud. Amen ba? No? Threefold repetition is a Hebrew way of expressing the superlative. Ang ibig sabihin, God is the holiest of all. Ug wala na jud lain. Amen. Number two, Jesus introduced himself as true. Tinuod siya. Sabihin natin, true. Dili siya Diyos-Diyosan. Kung dili, true siya, tinuod siya, authentic, genuine, real, a perfect God. John 14:6, sabi, Jesus declared himself, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." Na? And in Revelation 19:11, sabi ni John, "I saw heaven standing open, and there before me was a white horse whose rider is called Faithful and True." In other words, holy and true, Jesus is saying that I am Yahweh. No other God. I am Yahweh, Jehovah Adonai, the Lord, your master. As the one who is true, as the one who is real, perfect, Christ is the author of truth. Amen. Kahit anong false doctrines dyan, kahit anong perverted na teachings dyan, Jesus stands alone as the one who is completely true. And God, the Holy One of all. Amen. Number three, Jesus introduced himself as the one who has the key of David. What he opens, no one can close. And what he closes, no one can open. Na-experience na ba natin ito sa buhay natin? Amen? Amen? Yung mga opportunities na binigay ni God sa atin. Hallelujah. Isaiah 22 verse 20 to 23. Kayo na lang ho magbasa. Nakaano na dyan. Makikita din natin ito sa Isaiah 22. This refers to Hezekiah's servant na si Eliakim na binigyan niya ng authority over David's house, including access sa lahat ng mga kayamanan ng hari. In other words, gisulti ni sa Ginoo ba that I am the source of David. I am his Lord. Nasa akin ang full authority over salvation and judgment. I hold the key of the kingdom of heaven. No? Sabi nga, no, sabi ni Jesus, in other words ba na, I have the key to the real treasury. Treasures na dili magkalawang. Amen? Treasures na dili mudaan, like sa atuang mga sanina, mudaan atong sanina. Di ba? Amen? Like sa shoes, like sa bags na perting mahala, mudaan na siya. Tanaw ang bag sa imong katupad. Amen. Glory to God, no? Matingala ko karon dahang kaigbag na bastang mahala, million-million. Oo, no? Hallelujah. Mudaan ang balay, ang sakyanan. Pero ang kay Jesus, heavenly treasures. Ano itong mga heavenly treasures? Yung salvation po, heavenly treasures yan. Yung freedom from sin, yung forgiveness, yung kalipay. Nga gikan sa Ginoo. Amen? Palapakan natin si Lord. Ito mga heavenly treasures, maangkon lang jud nato na pinaagi kay Jesus. Ugwa na ilain. Amen. These three descriptions, pinakita niya si Jesus declaring His messianic authority, His sovereignty, and His deity. Amen. Number two, commendation. Ito lang ho, dalawa lang ho sa churches na walang rebuke, kundi ho commendation. The Smyrna and the Philadelphia. Commendation. Verse 8, I know all the things you do. Amen. Sabi ni Jesus, I know all. Sabi natin all. All the things you do. Alam niyo kung ano ang ginagawa po natin, it's either bad or good. Nakikita yan ng Panginoon. Sabi nga niya sa Proverbs 15:3, TPT version, hindi ko na lang nilagay dyan, sabi niya, the eyes of the Lord are everywhere and He takes notes of everything that happens. He watches over His lovers. Kisa ni mga lovers, ikaw yun. Sabihin mo sa katabi mo, ikaw yun. Kalami, no? Ang Ginoo magtanaw sa ato, ha? Amen? He watches over His lovers and He also sees the wickedness of the wicked. I know all the things you do and I have opened a door for you that no one can close. Hallelujah. I have opened a door. Ano po ba itong open door na sinasabi ni Jesus dito? In John 10, 7 to 15, Jesus declared Himself, I am the door. Amen. Sabi niya, I am the door. If anyone enters by me, he will be saved. And he will go in and out and find pasture. Then, he declared, in verse 11, I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd gives his life for his sheep. Hallelujah! Ang background po nito in Ezekiel 34, nga nakikita ni God, there are rulers of God's people were unfaithful. So God promised to Israel that na He will send a true shepherd to be their Savior. Amen. And this open door na sinasabi dito, is si Jesus po ito. Amen. Because He is, siya lang ang door. Amen. So this time, open door, Christians in Philadelphia did love one another because they love Jesus. Hallelujah. And this time, they spent together learning God's word and obey it. And they freely let everyone know that they were Christians. In other words ba, proud sila na magiging Christian sila. Amen? They let them know freely nga Christian. Proud sila na magiging Christian. Sa ato ba, proud ba ta na mahimutang Christian? Ha? Naiuban mo tago nga di Christian. Usay, mahibaluan na lang, ay Christian din na siya. Murag kuan man. Anak siya, no? So sa ato ba, ipakita yun nato nga Christian ta. Paano man sa ato ang mga actions and words that comes out in our mouth. Amen. So anong ginawa ni God? So God blessed them by opening wonderful opportunities. Ano po ba itong mga opportunities na ito? For them to share the gospel. For them to share the good news of salvation. Palapakan natin ang Panginoon. Kaya si Paul, ang prayer request ni Paul, ito po ang prayer request ni Paul sa mga churches na pinupuntahan niya. Colossians 4:3, sabi niya, and pray for us too, that God may open the door for our message so that we may proclaim the mystery of Christ for which I am in chains. Ganahan ka ko sa ICB version, International Children's Bible, sabi doon, also pray for us. Pray that God will give us an opportunity to tell people His message. Pray that we can preach the secret truth that God has made known about Christ. I am in prison because I preach this truth. Amen. And yes, si Paul na-experience yun niya ang open door. Hallelujah. In 2 Corinthians 2:12, sabi niya, "Now, when I went to Troas to preach the gospel of Christ and found that the Lord had opened a door for me." Question. Is praying for a person na may naay pangkinahanglan is an open door for us ba to share the love and the faithfulness of God? Yes or no? Yes or no? Yes. Amen. Hallelujah. Or may mga times sa buhay natin na sinabihan tayo ni God, ampuin na siya. We share ang word. Pero wala tayong gibuhat ba? Na-experience na ninyo ni? Kaya nga naman, nahadlok ka. Maulaw ka. Amen? No? Naabot ni sa ato ang life. Kaya, i-pray na to ni. Ako na-experience na ako na siya many times. When the Holy Spirit told me, i-pray, ana-ana. There was one time na grabe jud kaayong ako ang grabe kayo ako ang pagmahay. Because that person, namatay siya. Wala na ako siya naampuan. Grabe yun ko, sorry Lord. From that day on, kung musuti ang Ginoo, ampuin na siya, bahalag ka matyuno na siya, atuan yun na ako. Kaya dili ko gusto na mausap to nga feeling nga gisugo ko sa Ginoo. And glory to God, no, kanang, there was one time sa amo ang silingan giantuan jud ako, nag-volunteer jud ko nga kuan, glory to God, kay nakadawat jud siya sa Ginoo. Hallelujah. And there was one time also a cancer patient sa public nagpray ko, bahala na Lord, basta maampuan nako siya. Amen. And glory to God na nasa ato aba as we are following Jesus. Sabi ni Paul in Ephesians 6:19-20, sabi niya, "Also pray for me that when I speak, when I open my mouth, God will give me words so that I can tell the secret of the good news without fear. I have been sent to preach the good news, and I am doing that now here in prison. Pray that when I preach the good news, I will speak without fear as I should." E maumang yun ni ato ang ginabati, sahay mahadlok ta, maulaw ta. Amen? Muna siya, let's pray for it, na naagyod tay boldness to share the gospel. Amen? Amen. Palapakan natin si Lord. Hallelujah. Ang sabi pa ni Jesus, "You have little strength, gamay lang, yet you obeyed my word and not deny me." Ang Philadelphian Christians or the Philadelphia Church ay konti lang po in number. Gamay lang sila. They gather in houses. Kaya walay mga ruins, Christian temples, kasi they gather in houses. In other words, basta ato akaroon, naa sila sa mga simbalay. Amen. Pero, ang mga Bible scholars generally see that this statement as not a negative comment, but a commendation. Ang Philadelphia po, persecuted din po sila, just like the Smyrna. But anong ginawa nila? They still trust God. Number two, they faithfully obey God's word. And number three, did not deny His name. Okay, basahan natin ha, sa verse 7. "You have little strength, yet you obeyed my word and did not deny me." They did not deny His name, declaring that Jesus is Lord. They had maintained a faithful testimony by word and by action, despite sa mga persecution nga ng mga hintabo. Not worshiping other gods. Again, may mga emperor worship dito. Wala sila ng padala sa world system. Kay Roman Empire man sila ito nga time. And still follow Christ. Hallelujah. And number four, unsa ang pinakalami jud po daani, they enjoy the open door of spreading the gospel. Palapakan natin ang Panginoon. Mogi ni ato ang prayer karon, glory to God, na ma-enjoy jud nato ang open door of spreading the gospel. Here in the Philippines, amen? Naaman ta din sa Jensen, gibutang ta sa Ginoo, so ato ang i-conquer ang South Cotabato. Amen! Palapakan natin si Lord! Woo! Sabi ni MacArthur, ni Constable, they are theologians ni sila. The Philadelphia Church was small in numbers but had a powerful impact on this city. Despite its small size, spiritual power flowed in Philadelphia Church. People were redeemed, lives were being transformed, and the gospel of Jesus Christ was being proclaimed. Alam niyo po ba, ano ang promise ni Lord sa atin, sa Philadelphia Church at sa atin? Amen. Luke 12:32. Sabi niya, "Do not be afraid, little flock, because your Father has chosen to give you the kingdom." Sabihin mo sa sarili mo, do not be afraid. Hinay kaayo, do not be afraid. Speak up. Amen. Number three, ano po ba ang promise ni Lord? Yung reward ni Lord sa Philadelphia. Verse 9, look, I will force those who belong to Satan's synagogue or synagogue of Satan, kagaya ng Smyrna, those liars who say they are Jews but are not, to come and bow down at your feet. They will acknowledge that you are the ones I love. Sino po ba ito? Again, sino po ba ito, mga synagogue of Satan? These are the Jews that are persecuting the Christians, or to some scholars, sinasabi dito that ito ang mga Christians na hindi talaga real Christians. Gusulod sila sa isa ka church, again, no? Ganong gitawag ni synagogue of Satan, kasi si Satan is the accuser of the brethren, and these are the people na magsulod sila sa church. Mulingkod, o magtanaw-tanaw, o naasay, kanisikuan ba? Kanang simbahan na, kanang CCFI? Blah, 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 blah. O, anak, no? Manguha o laing membro sa ubang simbahan. O, mga iyon anak, no? Muna nga, sabi nga ni Walvoord, anong nangyayari? Anong gawin ni Jesus sa mga taong ito? Sabi ni Walvoord, they will be forced to acknowledge that Philadelphia Church were true servants of God. Amen. They will bow down at your feet. Ang ibig sabihin, they will acknowledge Jesus are the one I love. Bowing down shows total defeat and submission. Meaning, he would make even their enemies respect them, would one day realize that Christ loved his children and see Christ through Philadelphia Christians, that salvation will come also sa mga enemies. Kaya even sa karon, this is a promise po sa Ginoo sa Israel, that one day the Jews will come and bow down before the Lord and acknowledge Jesus as their Lord and Savior. Amen. Palapakan natin ang Panginoon. Kaya sa ating buhay po ngayon, if you are persecuted, glory to God, padayon ng taigsoon. Trust God. Amen. And God will give an open door for all of us. Amen. Verse 10. Because you have obeyed my command to persevere, I will protect you from the great time of testing that will come upon the whole earth to test those who belong to this world. Ano po ba itong great time of testing na sinasabi ng Panginoon? Because you have obeyed my command, I like this kanang kwan, to persevere. My command to persevere, my command to be faithful, my command to endure. Ang tawag ka natin dito is faithful endurance. Hallelujah. Ang sabi ni Lord, I will protect you from the great time of testing. Ano po ba itong great time of testing na sinasabi ni God sa atin, sa Philadelphia Church? Na God will protect us, dili ta makaagi og great tribulation. Amen? Amen? Sabihin mo sa katabi mo, be faithful. This verse also, sabi ng mga Bible scholars, this verse also supports the pre-tribulational rapture of the church. Oo, mauni siya, no? Muna sa ito ang mga kinabuhi, igsoon ba? Nga, maski unsa kalisod, padayon yun ta. Amen? Inay mong kaugalingon bi, padayon. Amen. Jesus promised them that they will not experience the great tribulation. Kaya since the Philadelphian Christians, nangamatay naman sila, this is also a promise sa atua sa Ginoo that if we remain faithful, hallelujah, Lord, if we remain faithful, we will not experience the great time of testing, the great tribulation. Amen. Verse 11, sabi ni God, I am coming soon. Hold on to what you have. Ito ang instruction ni Lord. Hold on to what you have so that no one will take away your crown. Ang Smyrna, sinabihan sila ni Jesus, if you remain faithful even unto death, I will give you the crown of life. Pero dito pare-pareho lang sila, no? Pero there is sa Philadelphia, hold on to what you have so that no one will take your crown. Ano itong hold on? Hold fast. Anong i-hold on natin? Sa ibang translation, hold fast. I-hold on natin ang truth of who Jesus is in your life. The truth of salvation. Now, hindi natin ipagpalit ang salvation kung ano man ang i-offer dito sa mundo. Yun ang gusto ni God. Mauna ang gusto sa Ginoo sa atoa. Ano bang i-offer? Anything na i-offer ng enemy sa'yo. Anything na i-offer ng world sa iyo. Prayer, this is our prayer ng salvation. Dili na to na siya ikuan. I-surrender lang, just like that. Amen? Sabi ni Jesus, hold on. Hold on to the Word of God. Hold on to the Word of God because the Word of God strengthens us. Because the Word of God keeps us aligned sa will ni Lord sa ato ang kinabuhi. Hangtod yun na siya mabalik. John 6:63, sabi, the words that I speak to you are spirit and they are life. Ano ba ang patay sa'yo? If you hold on ta sa word sa Ginoo, ang question dito, sabi nga, the word of God that I speak to you, sabi ni Jesus, they are spirit and they are life. Pero ang question dito, ano po ba ang patay sa buhay mo ngayon? Patay ba ang mga dreams mo na binigay yung God-given dream? No? Sa atoa, speak life. Baogin ni siya permanente. Speak life. Amen. May sakit ka ba? Speak healing. May pinag-pray ka ba sa mga ano mo, sa mga relatives mo? Speak salvation. Speak freedom. Amen. Speak Jesus sa mga family natin, sa life natin. Amen. Palakpakan natin si Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Proverbs 3, verse 5. Sabi doon, every word of God is pure. He is a shield to those who put their trust in Him. Pure. The word of God is pure. Kaya hold on. Hold fast to your justification. The purification na ginabuhat sa Ginoo sa tuang kinabuhi. Kaya may trials, may testing, may storm sa tuang mga kinabuhi. Kay this justifies us. Amen? Na this purifies us. Amen? Na ba kay trials karon? Hold on lang tadi sa Ginoo. Yeah. Bakit po ba mag-hold on tayo? Sabi ni God, so that no one will take your crown. Pwede dahi kawaton ang ato ang crown? anong klaseng crown ito? The crown of life. Glory to God. At marami pang crown na ano ibibigay. The imperishable crown. Kasali ba ito, Toro? The crown of rejoicing, the crown of righteousness, and the crown of glory. And verse 12, ang sabi niya, all who are victorious will become pillars. Sabihin natin, pillars. Unsa gani pillars sa Bisaya? Kanang poste, parehana poste. Mga foundation na sila. Pillars in the temple of my God, and they will never have to leave it. And I will write on them the name of my God, and they will be citizens in the city of my God. The new Jerusalem that comes down from heaven from my God, and I will also write on them my new name. Ano po ba itong pillar? Meron tayong ano dyan? Yan. Yan ang, kung pupunta tayo sa Turkey, makikita nato na siya. Usa na siya sa ruins na siya sa isang temple ata yan. Or isa ka church na saint something na church. Okay. Dako kayo siya nga pillar. Ano ibig sabihin ng pillar? Pillar symbolizes dignity, beauty, permanence, stability, strong body, dili ka matarog, and strength. Amen. Jesus make them strong and secure like pillars in the temple. Kung kita magpadayon diha sa Ginoo, Jesus will make us pillars in the temple. Amen. Palapakan natin si Lord. Malapit na tayong matapos. Okay. Ang history po, itong Philadelphia Church. As I've said kanina, ang Philadelphia era started in 1750, 17 naman yun noon, 1750 to 1906. By the Wesley, John Wesley. Siya po ang parang nagsalo sa ginawa ni God through Martin Luther ani nga time sa Sardis. Okay? Sinabi niya ni Toro yung last time. Ang age na ito, tinawag na Great Missionary Age. And the Great Open Door Age. Kaya nga, sa Wesley, played an important role. Founder siya ng Methodist Church. Glory to God. Si John Wesley and Charles Wesley, and together with George Whitefield. Siguro kini si John Charles Wesley, na sige na kong basa sa iyang biography, daghan ka siyang nasulat na mga songs, including The Heart, The Herald Angels Sing. Siya ang nagsulat ani. Siguro, ano siya, yung worship leader siya ni John Wesley. Okay. This time, meron na pong Wesleyan Church, Baptist Church, Methodist Church, Assemblies of God. they gathered together, si John Wesley stood up and went to these churches. Sabi niya, wala na tayo name sa atong organization karon. We'll be one. We'll be united. Kaya, when they nag-gather sila, yung sinabi ko kanina, they study the word together, they prayed together. Then, in 1790s and 1850s, nahitabo ang Great Awakening. Second and third Great Awakening. Ang ibig sabihin, nagkaroon ng revival. Dito, sa mundo. Amen. May renewal, may healing, may hope. Kaya, with this na sa nahitabo sa ilaha, nagkaroon sila ng revival, si William Carey, in 1793, he went to India. William Carey, tanaw na to ang ihangkoan. Yeah, went to India. Robert Morrison went to China in 1807. Sabi pa nga niya, may nainangutana sa iyahang nga press. When asked by God, by the press, before going as a missionary to China, do you really expect you can make an impression on the great Chinese Empire? Kay grabe man gyud ang Chinese Empire. Ano sabi ni Morrison? No, sir. I expect God to do it. Amen. Palapakan natin si Lord. Kaya grabe di ay kaayo ang mga grabe kayo ang mga Christians karon sa China. Amen. Hallelujah. Robert Moffat in 1817 and David Livingstone in 1841, they went to Africa. And meron din dito si Jonathan Edwards. Hallelujah. The British and Foreign Bible Society was organized in 1804. Sinabi ito ni Toro last Sunday because kailangan nila ng translation sa Biblia. Because alam nila na ang word ni God ang makastrengthen sa atin, sa kanila. Then, in 1816, the American Bible Society was kanang established, was organized ani nga time. So grabe kaayo ni nga revival and glory to God na abot sa Pilipinas. Hallelujah, palapakan natin ang Panginoon. Hallelujah. And this revival will not stop. Amen. Kay gamiton man kas Ginoo igsuon. Ingnay mo katapad gamiton kas sa Ginoo. Ay, wala ang uban. Dili sila gusto. Ha? Palakpakan na to si Lord, B. Dili mo gusto na gamiton ta sa Ginoo. Amen? Ako gusto dyan ko gamiton ko sa Ginoo. Amen? No, Revelation 17:14 in conclusion. Sabi, Revelation 17:14, this will make war with the Lamb, and the Lamb will overcome them. For He is the Lord of lords and King of kings. And to those who are with Him, linyahin na sa inyohang Bible, and to those who are with Him are called, chosen, and faithful. Called ka ba? Gitawag ba ka sa Ginoo? Pinili ka ba sa Ginoo? Faithful ba diha sa Ginoo? Ngano sila gitawag nga faithful church? Saan ba sila faithful? Ito sa Philadelphian church. Faithful sila in reading and studying and obeying the word of God. Ito ho ang secret nila in abiding in the Lord. Is abiding in the Word of God. Kaya, nagiging solid po ang foundation nila. alam nila na unsa ka importante ang word sa Ginoo. Kaya nga naay Bible Society ani nga time. And nagiging solid jud ang ilahang foundation. And with that, as they are reading the Word of God, studying the Word of God, obeying the Word of God, no, nagiging ready po ang ilang heart to what God is giving to them. Kaya ang promise ni Lord sa kanila is an open door that no one can shut. Question, sa buhay po natin ngayon, are we faithful sa word life natin? Sa devo life natin, in reading the word, meditating the word, kung na-fail ka again and again, sabi nga ng mga senior pastors natin, kay si Tora sa bishop, si Tora at si bishop, balik lang, wag mong hayaan na ano po, na hindi ka magbasa ng Bible, hindi ka mag-meditate ng Bible. Maumanggod ni ang makastrengthen sa atoa. Amen? Are we obeying God's command? Ang desire po ba natin in knowing the Lord nag-increase? Alam niyo po, kinidyod ang ako ang gusto na maatubang. When I face the Lord, mauni ang gusto na ako na madunggan ako sa Ginoo. In Matthew 25:21. Gusto na ako mag-atubang ko sa Ginoo, ingnan ko sa Ginoo. Well done, good and faithful servant. You have been faithful and trustworthy over a little. I will put you in charge of many things. Share in the joy of your master. In anak po ba, pod, ang ato ang gusto na madunggan nato sa Ginoo? Or in Matthew 7:21-23, not everyone who says to me, Lord, Lord, shall enter the kingdom of heaven, but he who does the will of my Father in heaven. Diba, Lord, I cast out demons? At tupagani ko sa simbahan? Ato gani ko, I do things, unsa ang unsa? Pero ingon ang Ginoo, and then I will declare to them, I never knew you. Depart from me, you who practice lawlessness. It's your choice, mga kapatid. Amen? May I request everybody to please stand. God's desire for His church is to be faithful. Faithful till the end. Faithful till Jesus comes. Maabot si Jesus sa second coming. And one thing na di, nga iyaha yung promise ato is that dili gyud ta maka experience sa great tribulation. Amen. Father God, this is our prayer today. Nakita ka Lord sa mo ang mga kasing-kasing karon. Nakita ka Lord sa amo ang mga plano sa amo ang kinabuhi. Nakakita ka Lord kung unsa mi diha kanimo, Father God. Father, forgive us sa mga times sa buhay namin that we are not faithful to you. Forgive us sa mga time sa mga time Lord na dapat namong buhaton para mag-grow me diha kanimo, pero wala namo ginabuhat. Because, Lord God, giuna namo ang mga butang, Lord, that we think that is more important than spiritual things. Forgive us, Lord. Cleanse us. Purify us, O God. And Lord, this is our desire today, this is our prayer today, Jesus. Increase the passion, Lord God, of knowing you more, of loving you more. Increase the hunger and thirst for you, Jesus, of reading your word, oh God. We want to please you, Jesus. We want, oh Jesus, na pag-atubang namo diha kanimo, Lord God. Imo ming i-welcome. Welcome, my good and faithful servant. As we continue walking with you, Lord God, Holy Spirit, we pray, take full control over our lives. Lord, kung nalihis man mi, Lord God, sa imuhang will, sa mo ang kinabuhi, birahag yun mi, Ginoo, pabalik sa imuhang will, Lord God. Bahalag sakit, Lord, basta naka-align ni sa imuhang will, sa imuhang purpose, sa among kinabuhi, Father God. Salamat kaayo, Lord. We pray, Lord God, naganahan jud mi magbasa sa imuhang word, sa imong Bible. Dili namo siya ineglect, O God. Kay nakahibalo mi, mauni ang makastrengthen ka namo, Father God. Nakahibalo mi nga pinaagi ni Lord God, among foundation diha sa imuha, Lord, malig-on. Thank you, Lord. We bless your name. We love you, Jesus. In Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Palapakan nato ang Panginoon. Kanita muling kod. Sa mga first-timers po namin, meron po bang first-timers dito? Amen. Glory to God. Sabi ni Jesus, John 14:6, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. Hindi ho ang religion ang makasave po natin, sa atin. Hindi po ang ato ang pagkabuutan o pagtabang sa uban, kundi si Jesus ang ato ang way of salvation. Si Jesus ang ato ang way to the Father. Si Jesus lang ho ang makapasaylo sa ato ang mga sala. Si Jesus lang ho ang makahatag sa ato ang freedom from sin. Amen. Glory to God. All ang ato alang yung buhaton karon. Let's pray this prayer and ask Jesus to come into our heart and believe by faith nga siya jud ang ato ang Ginoo, ato ang Savior. Amen. Let's pray this prayer. Lord Jesus, thank you for your word. I declare, O God, that you are the way, the truth, and the life. Father, forgive me of my sin. Wash me, Lord. Cleanse me, Lord. And salamat kaayo, Ginoo, nga ikaw nagapasaylo sa ako ang mga sala. And ask you, Jesus, to come into my heart. Be my Lord. Be my Savior. Himuag, Ginoo, na makaila pa jud ko kung kinsa ka sa ako ang kinabuhi. Salamat, Lord, sa imuhang gibuhat sa ako ang kinabuhi. Make me a person that you want me to be. A faithful woman or man of God. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. Palapakan natin si Lord. Woo!
Amen. What time is it? It's time to give in 2 Corinthians 9:7. Let's read together 2 Corinthians 9:7. Each one must give as he has decided in his heart, not reluctantly or under compulsion, for God loves a cheerful giver. Come on, let's pray. Our Father in heaven, with hearts full of gratitude, we come before you, offering what you have so generously provided. We give not out of obligation, but out of love and thankfulness for all that you have done for us. Lord God, accept these tithes in obedience to your word, Lord, as a token of our devotion and a symbol of our trust in your provision. May this be used to further your work on earth, to bring hope, comfort, salvation to those in need. Bless our giving, Lord, and teach us to give with joyful hearts, knowing that in your hands, our offerings can make a difference. Lord God, help us to be always generous, reflecting your own boundless generosity. We praise you and we glorify you, God. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Let's give! Isang magandang umaga sa lahat at welcome po sa Christian Church Fellowship International. Welcome especially to our new friends this morning. Stay tuned for our announcements. Here's our Sunday service schedule, 10 a.m., 2 p.m., and 5:30 p.m. Visit us on our official Facebook, Instagram, and YouTube account where we post our recorded service later this evening. Join us at Don't Prayer Meeting every first Saturday of the month, 5 a.m. Posted on screen is our BPI account, GCash, and PayMaya number in case you find it more convenient to give online. A happy, happy, happy birthday to those who are celebrating their birthdays this week. Happy birthday!
Come on, let's stand. Sino pong na-bless ngayong umaga? Amen. Hallelujah. Come on, let's raise our hands into our receiving mode.
The Lord bless you and keep you and make His face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn His face toward you and give you peace.
blessed Sunday, everyone. God bless.